Today I'm house hunting in Italy, in and around the spectacular walled city of Lucca. Its stunning architecture, rolling hills and beautiful beaches have been attracting British buyers to this corner of Tuscany for decades. And with such a wide selection of property on offer, it's a great place to buy that dream home. I'm Laura Hamilton, and for the past 12 years I've been buying, renovating and selling property with a fair bit of success. Over the last 4 years, I've been helping buyers to find their dream homes both in the UK and overseas. We've spent this summer travelling around Europe searching for great houses at brilliant prices in popular summer sun destinations. In many parts of Spain, Italy and France, the property market is changing fast, and for the first time in many years, some agents think this could be the start of a new house price boom. Are they right? Stick with us and decide for yourself. Today I'm house hunting with Lynn and Lee Fox from Rotherham. They just love the Italian way of life and dream of spending more quality time together in their very own Tuscan holiday home. With a budget of £170,000, they're looking for a character property as close as possible to the cosmopolitan city of Lucca. Lee and Lynn have been married for 17 years and first started going to Italy after Lee, who's a mechanical maintenance engineer, was sent there for work. Lynn would often join him, and they already have Italian friends.
I don't think there's anywhere on earth to beat it. The rolling hills of Tuscany, it's just so peaceful and tranquil.
It's just the whole culture, the food, the wine, the weather. It's just everything. I think you just feel a lot more relaxed through it.
Lee works shifts and Lynn runs her own hairdressing business, so they want a second home in the Italian city of Lucca where they can relax.
We're looking forward to standing back now and taking an easier look at life. Now, like, thinking more about us.
Us, yeah.
Lynn and Lee have a part cash, part mortgage budget of £170,000.
I just can't wait, actually. I just want to be there now.
The city of Lucca and its surrounding province lie in the region of Tuscany in northwest Italy. It can be easily reached from the UK with direct daily flights from many UK airports to Pisa, which is half an hour away by car or train. Often called the jewel of Tuscany, Lucca's untouched, beautiful and varied landscape offers something for everyone. Packed with olive groves, lakes and mountains, and with a coast nearby, it's possible to take a dip in the sea and ski down a snow slope all in the same day. But the main draw for many is the walled city of Lucca itself, with its rich history and vibrant cafe culture.
Tuscany is one of the most popular places in Italy for the British to buy, and one of the most expensive, especially in the area in the so-called Golden Triangle between Pisa, Florence and Siena. But if you go further north to the Lucca province, property can be around 30% cheaper. And with the property market still suffering after the crash, now is a great time to get yourself a home brimming with Tuscan charm, but without the premium price tag.
I'm catching up with local property expert Riccardo Tognoschi, who's been selling property here for 7 years, to find out more.
My house hunters have a budget of £170,000. Mm-hmm. What could they expect to get?
With that budget, inside the city, you might expect to find two bedrooms, or, if you are quite lucky, sometimes three bedrooms, but maybe you have to make some renovations.
Okay.
Outside the city, you can find properties talking about, for example, a detached house with the stones and the rustic, the beams inside the houses, with at least three bedrooms.
And when it comes to negotiating and making offers on the price of the property, I like to be a bit cheeky. How low below the asking price am I able to pitch my offers?
You can expect a 5 to 10% discount.
Lee and Lynn have picked a good time to start house hunting. I just need to get a better idea about what type of property they're looking for.
Lynn and Lee, welcome back to Lucca.
Thank you.
This is somewhere you guys have visited many times before, haven't you, Lynn?
We have, yes, yeah, many times.
And what is it about this place, then, that you guys love so much?
I think it's the quality of life and the pace of life. It's the laid-back approach that we're both looking for.
So what is your ideal holiday home.
I don't think we really know exactly what we want until we actually see it. We definitely know we want 2 bedrooms. If it's a detached property, maybe a little bit of land, but we're quite open to other options.
Which areas do you like? Do you like to be in the thick of things, where there's buzzing atmosphere and the restaurants and bars, or do you prefer to be slightly further away?
I think we like the bars and restaurants.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think in the thick of things, as in like really in the centre, maybe just on the outskirts or something, but not too far.
You would be open to potentially looking at areas that may be slightly further away as well?
Yeah.
What do you want to spend?
Our maximum budget for the ideal property is £170,000.
Mm. Is there any room to go above that, or is that pretty much it?
Maybe slightly, but it would have to be something that didn't need any renovation work or modernisation.
How much are you sort of planning on using this place? What's the plan sort of for the future years going forward?
So I think initially, obviously, it would be maybe, four or five weeks out of the year. And then obviously with longer weekends, in the hope to just obviously gradually build that up until we do maybe eventually move out here, which is what we're intending to do.
So you ready to get on with this search?
Yes, it'd be good.
Let's do it.
We're starting our search right here within Luca's city walls, where its medieval and Renaissance buildings form a colourful backdrop, marrying old and new to create a unique atmosphere.
So, guys, this place probably needs no introduction to you, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Do you want to tell me where we are?
I'll let you lead.
Yeah, we're in the amphitheatre in the centre of Luca. It's the centre of Luca, really, and it's the place where we spend most of our time.
Is it?
Yeah, we do.
So you know all these bars and restaurants, do you? Have you got a favourite?
We've eaten in quite a few of them.
Yeah.
And I think we've drunk in all the bars.
Yeah. So we tend to come down for coffee in the morning, and then we'll have a wander around and come back for lunch. And
then in the afternoon we'll come back. And it's just a place where you can sit and just watch the world go by.
So how would you feel about owning a holiday home that was literally a stone's throw from this place?
I think it would be absolutely amazing.
Maybe we better come and look then.
Property within the city walls of Luca can cost twice as much as similar houses elsewhere in the province. Studio apartments here come with a starting price of around £90,000. But we've found a much bigger property that I think could be a perfect pied-à-terre for Lynn and Lee, which comes in well below their £170,000 budget.
Now, guys, as I promised, we are inside the city walls, which you can see just there, and we're looking at the first property in front of us right here.
Oh, wow.
Now, it's obviously not the whole thing.
No.
It's a 2-bedroom, second floor apartment. So it's actually the property with the shutters that are open that you can see. And the door to the right-hand side is a little Juliet balcony.
Nearly inside the walls, which is what we wanted.
Can we afford it?
This place is on the market just under £146,000. Wow. What's going through your mind? Because you're...
I think it's excitement, because I didn't think we'd ever be able to afford a property within the walls.
This second floor apartment inside the medieval walls of Luca has a dual aspect, offering views out over the surrounding city. Inside, it's been recently modernised and has an open plan living dining room with wiring and plumbing for a kitchen, which would cost between £4,000 and £5,000 to fit. To one side of the main living space is a generously sized master bedroom and a second guest bedroom, and to the other is a bathroom, which the owner will finish before selling. It's on the market at just under £146,000.
So in you come.
Oh, wow. It's a lot lighter than what I thought it was going to be.
It's just been renovated, hasn't it?
It has. It's newly renovated.
I'm just thinking about taking a wall out.
You're not?
Yeah.
Well, which one would you take out? And why?
I'd try and take that part of the wall out and open this up somehow.
To kind of fetch it into...
Just to fetch it into the rest of the apartment.
So as you walk through here, the wall that Lee will be knocking down, This is your main living area. Kitchen, open plan, with a dining room, or would you make it your living space?
I'd keep it as a kitchen dining
area. Kitchen dining area, I would say.
So This room, one of your bedrooms. Or could it be a living room if you were using that as a kitchen diner?
I think we'd keep this as a bedroom.
Yes, it's quite a nice size, isn't it?
Yeah, plus the view out of the window.
And the view out of the window.
How are you feeling about the building now we're inside?
I think I'm not sure at the moment.
I think it's going to be a head decision with this, not
yeah,
a heart.
Yeah, not a heart.
But
it's going to be, this is going to be practical.
Yeah.
Whilst you figure out what that is, head, heart, if you can see it working for you guys, why don't you just have a wander and I'll meet you back out front.
Okay, no problem. Bathroom. It's quite small, do you think?
Yeah, I like the tiles. I'm just not keen on the cables and the pipework.
Quite a nice area.
I love the floor tiles. The floor tiles are our taste.
Yeah.
Completely. I like it. Yeah. It's just compact.
This second floor city apartment in Lucca has recently been modernised. It has two bedrooms and comes with an asking price of just under £146,000.
So, what did we make of it?
It's really nice.
It was interesting. It took us somewhere else where we didn't think we were going to be, because we never thought that we'd be able to afford somewhere within the walls.
Mm-hmm.
And it's on the small side, but if we had a property like this, we'd consider it as a rental kind of possibility.
As opposed to something that we're going to retire into later on.
So it's definitely made, you think?
Definitely.
Oh, yeah.
And we've definitely got a potential contender.
Uh-huh. I think so.
Coming up, our second property really hits the sweet spot for Lee.
Right,
now I'm smiling.
Today, I'm with Lynn and Lee Fox from Rotherham, helping them find their dream home near the Italian city of Lucca. With a budget of up to £170,000, they're looking for somewhere as close to the historic centre as possible with bags of character.
So far in Lucca, where they already have friends, we've shown them this city apartment with an open plan design and two bedrooms. On the market for just under £146,000, Lee and Lynn felt it was on the small side, but were thrilled that they could afford a bolt hole within the walls of their favourite city. Next, I want to show them how much more space they can get for their money just a short drive from the city of Lucca through the stunning Tuscan countryside. We've come to the vineyards of Monte Carlo, famed for their award-winning white and sparkling wines, which in the past have been served at Italian royal weddings. Today, you can have your own tasting for around £7. And with their love of wining and dining, I'm hoping Lee and Lynn will like the area.
So guys, we've come 25 minutes from Lucca to this area called Monte Carlo. It's famous for its wine festival. Do you know when the wine festival is here?
No, but I think we might come.
Well, it's the last week of August, first week of September.
Right.
Is that something you quite like to do then when you come here, go to the wine festivals, a bit of wine tasting?
Yeah, we always like to go to the local festivals. It's something that we've done in quite a few of the villages where we've visited.
Yeah.
And we've been to the pumpkin festivals and the tomato festivals. And
Every village seems to have its own festival, so...
Any excuse
really
for
good.
A party, really.
The hilly area around Monte Carlo is increasingly sought after by cash-rich Russian and German buyers looking for large restored farmhouses. But further down the slopes, where terraced village properties are more common, the market is yet to pick up, and average prices can be a third lower. There are some good deals to be had, and I'm taking Lee and Lynn just 2 miles away from the vineyards to see a property in the village of Gragnano that's well within their £170,000 budget.
So, here we are.
Oh, wow.
This was one house, and the current owner has divided it into three properties.
Mm-hmm.
See this small window here? That is the property. If you draw a line down the centre of the property, that side is yours. And look, space.
Yeah, outside space.
Are either of you into gardening?
Well, I like to potter about in the garden. It's quite a bit bigger than what we have at home.
Yeah. It's manageable.
It's currently priced at just under £117,000.
Wow. 17?
Yeah, you heard me right.
It's quite good.
Now I'm smiling.
This This terrace house is one of four properties within a converted 100-year-old farmhouse and comes with a good-sized front garden. The owner is an interior designer for an international glossy magazine, and inside the house has been stylishly renovated to make the most of its original stonework and exposed beams. Downstairs it has a large traditional kitchen and combined living dining area with a staircase leading to the upper floor where there are two ample double bedrooms. With an asking price of just under £117,000, it's considerably below Lee and Lynn's £170,000 budget.
Come on through, guys.
Nice. I really love that wall.
What do you think of the kitchen?
It may have to be changed, maybe.
Oh, well, that was quite... It will have to be changed. Or it may have to be
may
changed.
Have to
no,
be
it
changed.
Will have to
yeah.
be changed. Yeah.
Just to get into our what we like, really.
Mm-hmm. Like to mix traditional with modern.
Yeah. And do it that way, I think.
Do you be cooking or would you be cooking, Lee?
We both
do a bit.
Yeah.
Something that you enjoy doing together?
Yeah, we do, yeah. Yeah, we don't fall out over cooking, do we? We're
no.
quite good.
Okay, here we go. So, bedroom there, bathroom there, into another bedroom just here.
The beams yeah. are nice.
I like the beams, yeah. I've always liked the exposed beams.
Have you?
Yeah.
What about those views out that window? Could you imagine waking up and looking at that?
The views are amazing.
Yeah.
I'm maybe just starting to feel it's a little bit on the dark side.
The property also comes with the option of buying a detached plot of land to the rear. Accessed from the side of the house, it also has a swimming pool. It currently doesn't have planning permission, but the agent says this will be obtained by the owner by the time of sale.
Did you ever imagine owning a property with a swimming pool?
No.
It's a bit of a swimming pool that needs a bit of maintenance. To buy this plot of land, it will cost you around £14,500
right.
extra
okay.
on top of the purchase price. But given that this place is so far under your budget,
yeah.
even with this plot of land, it's still within budget.
It's still within budget,
oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Do you think this would be something you would be interested in?
I think so. It gives us an extra
outside. It gives
outside.
Us a bit of an extra outside space, even though obviously it's on the opposite side.
It would be nice if the house was there
yeah.
and
yes.
this was the back garden.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
so.
Why don't you go and have a look around
okay.
the house and see how you feel then. We'll meet back out front.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is the bathroom. Oh, with the washing machine. I think the tiles might need to be changed. They're a little bit
yeah,
dated
the dated,
now, aren't
yeah.
they? Feels a little bit on the tight side, do you think?
I'd swing a cat, but I think it'd have a headache.
This is the second bedroom. Again, the beams have gone all the way through, haven't they?
Quite like the upstairs space, except the bathroom. I just think the bathroom needs updating.
Yeah.
This converted farmhouse has been carefully renovated to retain its original rustic features. It comes with two spacious bedrooms and a sizeable front garden. On the market for just under £117,000, there's also an option to buy this rear plot of land with a swimming pool for an additional £14,500.
So, what did you think?
It's a lovely property. I think it's a little on the small side.
Yeah, and a little bit dark, I think, as well, inside.
Character's good. We've just got to work
yes.
on the space
yeah.
inside
good.
The house.
The outside
yes.
space is perfect
yeah.
as well. Maybe if the land was attached, it would be absolutely
it would
fantastic.
Be
it feels
yeah.
a little bit disjointed.
Yeah, disjointed,
yes.
yeah.
I still have three more chances to find Lee and Lynn the perfect home. But first, I'm taking time to find out what owning a second home in Italy really means to them.
You both work incredibly hard and you don't get to spend that much time together, do you?
No, we don't. We probably spend one day a week together. Quality time, really.
So how do you think life will differ when you own a holiday home out here in Tuscany?
Yeah, I think we'll be able to make more time because we've got a genuine reason to
yeah,
come
to
out
come
here.
Out, yeah.
Why is it now that you've decided this is the right time?
We finished paying the mortgage on our house in England 2 years ago. And really, it's a matter that we don't want to waste the money that we have. We want to actually make some use of it. So even though we don't have children, we still have godchildren, we have nieces and nephews, and it's going to be something that we can leave to them. And we just don't want to waste it. We want to actually do some good.
What are you most excited about?
I think it's the prospect of actually owning a property, knowing that we can just come whenever we want. Mm. We've not got to, like, plan too far ahead. So we can come out a lot more often, can't we, then?
Yeah.
Coming up, Lynn and Lee decide the more's the merrier when they see the size of our next property.
4 bedrooms too many?
No.
No.
Not at all.
Yeah,
not
at all. Never have too many friends.
Lynn and Lee Fox from Rotherham are looking for a taste of Tuscany in the countryside surrounding the historical city of Lucca. With a budget of £170,000, they're searching for a holiday home where they can relax and enjoy the Italian way of life. They would also like a property where they can entertain the many friends they've made on previous visits. So far, we've shown Lee and Lynn this city apartment with 2 bedrooms in Lucca on the market for just under £146,000. Situated just a short stroll from the city centre bars and restaurants, it could be the perfect holiday bolt hole. And although they didn't love it, they thought it was so practical, it's a real contender. Then we took them to see this stylishly converted farmhouse with 2 bedrooms and an asking price of just under £117,000. While they didn't appear smitten, they did appreciate all its outdoor space and they haven't ruled it out. Next, we're heading back towards Lucca, to the small town of San Pietro Avico. Colourful and picturesque, it's just 3 miles outside the city, and it's popular with commuters who work there and students who attend Lucca's 3 universities. What are your first impressions of this place?
It's actually quite a quaint little town, isn't
it? Yeah, it is. It looks really pretty, actually, with the coloured dirt buildings and everything. Yeah.
This road will take you straight into Lucca in around 10 minutes.
Okay.
Oh, so we're not far at all. However, I know you guys like to go out and have a glass of wine or two.
Yeah.
If you don't want to drive, it's actually got its own train station.
Oh, oh really?
Yeah, that's good.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So you can get a train into Lucca for around £1.
Wow, that's good. Oh, that's good.
It only runs until 9 o'clock at night, so you might have to get a taxi back. Yeah. How does that sound?
That sounds good. That's 10 minutes. It's okay, that.
Despite being so close to the city of Lucca, property prices in San Pietro remain significantly lower, so Lynn and Lee will get a lot more for their money. And since they're also considering retiring here, I found them a property which I also think could be suitable as a future permanent home.
Our third property, just here.
This looks good.
This looks bigger.
Yes, well, it is bigger. 4 bedrooms.
Oh, 4? Wow.
That's good.
4 bedrooms too many?
No.
No.
Not at all.
Yeah, you never have too many friends.
And you've also got a garden here that's sort of L-shaped, so it sweeps along here and then round the back. Now, this place is on the market just under £190,000. Yeah. However, the owner has said she would accept an offer of the minimum of £171,500. Okay. So it is just a smidge over the top end of your budget. But I truly believe this is a property that you could retire into.
Yeah, definitely.
Although that is a few years off yet.
Yeah.
I think, you know, view it with that in mind.
Okay.
Yeah.
This 3-storey end of terrace house is one of 6 properties within an old barn conversion. To the side and back, it has a large L-shaped garden with lawn, trees and rose beds, and a terrace with a gazebo for eating and entertaining al fresco. Inside, on the ground floor, it has a good-sized living room and a separate kitchen come dining room. Upstairs, on the 2nd floor, there are 3 bedrooms and a family bathroom. And on the top floor, there's an extremely spacious 4th bedroom with exposed beams. It's on the market for just under £190,000, which is over budget, but the agent says an offer of around £171,500 would be accepted.
Straight in.
Oh, this is nice.
The living room.
This is lovely.
Yeah?
It is.
Nice mix of character. Look at the beams.
Yeah.
And modern. What do you think of the floor?
The floor's lovely.
Yeah, I like the floor very much.
Can you imagine yourself sat there?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'd put a corner sofa in.
Yeah.
So you're visualising how it can work for yourselves already.
Definitely, yeah.
Into your kitchen diner.
I quite like this.
A little bit of clutter, maybe.
Yes. Yeah, we're not a great lover of open shelves, are we?
No.
Up here, you've got 2 bedrooms behind us and a bathroom. And then you have a 3rd bedroom through here. And I don't know if you noticed as we walked past, there's actually another set of steps that leads you up to the 4th bedroom. It has got 4 bedrooms. I just wondered, have you ever considered bringing your business out here to Italy, and would you have a little hairdressing room?
If we did decide to come out here earlier, mm-hmm. maybe I could do something like that.
Yeah.
So it's a thought that we've had, isn't it?
Yeah, but I'd really like to come out here and just have no ties like that.
Yeah.
Not have to work. I'd love to not have to work. I'd love to not have to work now, but...
Does Lynn enjoy her job a bit more than you enjoy yours, then?
No, I think we both enjoy work, but I think we both enjoy work because we can actually see the end.
Yeah.
I think
it's like work-wise, Lee's job's quite a heavy job, mm-hmm. whereas obviously mine, it's probably more of a social job as opposed to...
Well, that's what I'm thinking, actually. Yeah, when you come out here, your job is almost an opportunity to... Meet people, isn't it,
yeah.
in the area?
Yeah.
Have a look around then.
Okay.
See if you would want to knock down any walls, how you would make the house work for you, and then we'll meet back out front.
Okay.
Small.
Small office, isn't it, really, as opposed to a bedroom? Well, this is a little bit bigger, isn't it?
I can't see my brother or your sister again.
On a bunk bed. This would make a good guest bedroom. If friends came over with children, they could still be on this one level.
This barn conversion has a good-sized garden and offers a large amount of living space with 4 bedrooms and a separate kitchen and living room. It has an asking price of just under £190,000, but the agent has told us that it could come down within reach of Lee and Lynn's £170,000 budget.
Hi! What do you think of the house?
I really like the house. Okay. Love it, yeah.
Yeah, we both like it. I think Lynn loves it more than me. The main reservation that I have is close proximity of the neighbours. Just have the thing about opening the window in the morning, open the doors and there's the next door neighbour looking at you. Don't want to upset them, know when we have the late night raves and things.
Okay, let's head to the next property.
Okay,
thank you.
So in search of a bit more privacy, we're heading to another hillside town called Borgo Abogiano, which is only about half an hour's drive from the city of Lucca. As it's built on a hill, the town has an upper and lower level. It's a lively place with around 9,000 mainly Italian residents, and it offers plenty of amenities and activities.
This town is called Borgo Abogiano, and there's everything that you could possibly want here. Bars, restaurants. What do you think of this place?
It seems quiet, but it's the afternoon, so it does tend to be a little bit quieter.
What's the Italian version of the siesta?
Siesta.
Oh. Well, there you go. Do you think being somewhere like this would be a nice place to live, a nice place to come on holiday?
It could be a nice base. Yeah,
nice place to like base ourselves so that we can go into Lucca or the coast or whatever. Yeah.
At the last property we showed them, Lynn and Lee were worried about being too close to the neighbours. So I found a property within a farmhouse conversion where Lee could open the doors to the balcony without the neighbours seeing him.
Here we have a front garden that the house overlooks, but it's all yours.
I do like the outside.
Yeah, it has a proper terrace as well. Yeah.
This place is on the market for £175,000. It's been on the market for a couple of years, so I think there'll be some room to negotiate on the price.
Okay.
Have a good look at this place on your own.
Okay.
And I'll meet you back out front.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck.
This 2-storey terrace house is one of 6 properties in a farmhouse conversion and comes with a large front garden with a lawn and terrace with a built-in barbecue. It also has a private terrace with a shared back courtyard and a balcony from which to enjoy fantastic views of the town and countryside. Inside on the ground floor, there is a sizeable living room with French doors leading out to the back courtyard. And to the side is a connected dining room and country-style kitchen. Upstairs, there's a family bathroom and 2 double bedrooms. The master bedroom has French doors giving access to the balcony. The property's been on the market for 2 years, and it has a current asking price of just over £175,000.
This is quite big, actually.
Yeah, it's bigger than I thought it was going to be.
The stairs are nice.
Yeah, you can tell it's a new build.
Yeah, it's quite clean lined and everything, isn't it? That goes all the way around.
All right.
That's really nice, that's different. The units are quite nice as well, aren't they?
Kind of oldie-worldy, but modern.
Yeah, the kitchen units are fine, I can live with them for now. But I think at some point, I'm going to want to change them. Oh, this is the courtyard.
Could put a little patio table out there, maybe. Could have an aperitivo in the evening.
There is privacy. But I wouldn't like to stay out there all the time.
No. Okay, this is the bathroom. This is quite nice.
Nice shower. It is one of the nicest bathrooms we've seen.
Yeah, the tiles are nice. This is one of the bedrooms.
Wardrobes, make it too oppressive
maybe,
again.
Maybe it look a bit too small.
Yeah, you need lighter wardrobes.
Okay, so this is the other bedroom.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Walking wardrobe.
Yeah. It's the best views of the lot, isn't it?
Yeah, it's quite a nice size as well. We'd be able to sit out here.
I like the property. I think the plus point of this is the garden.
Yeah.
I think the downside for us is the position.
The position, yeah.
This terrace house has two bedrooms and comes with a lot of indoor and outdoor space, including a balcony offering splendid views of the town and countryside. It's on the market slightly over budget, with a negotiable asking price of just over £175,000.
Hi, guys.
Hi. Hello.
I'm intrigued to hear what you think of this place.
It had good and bad points, really.
OK, so tell me the good.
The good point, obviously, the outside space at the front. Mm-hmm. And also inside, it did have really clean lines. It didn't have the character of the last property. It was still clean, and the bedrooms were really
nice
light
size.
And airy, really nice.
But I think it's the fact that the property's not a detached property. I think that's kind of what Lee's maybe veering to.
Yeah, it's probably right. That's probably
so it's
really
the
that
detached.
Is probably the dream. Yeah, I would say so.
Well, I've got one last shot at this, guys.
Okay.
Follow me.
Okay.
Next, we have one last surprise for Lynn and Lee.
Have you noticed anything, Lee?
It's detached.
Today I'm helping Rotherham couple Lynn and Lee Fox find a home in the historic city of Lucca. They dream of spending more time together, immersed in the Italian culture and lifestyle. Lynn and Lee said they were open to seeing all kinds of property in and around the city of Lucca where they have friends. They liked this city apartment with two bedrooms for the asking price of just under £146,000, as they thought it would make a great holiday bolt hole, although they couldn't see themselves retiring there permanently. This tastefully converted farmhouse with two bedrooms is also still in the running and is on the market for just under £117,000. But they've ruled out this barn conversion with four bedrooms and a negotiable asking price of just under £190,000 because it didn't offer them enough privacy. And although more secluded, they've also dismissed this terrace house with two bedrooms and a negotiable asking price of just over £175,000 as they still felt encroached upon by neighbours. To find a detached property of the type I think Lee and Lynn now want, but within budget, I'm taking them an hour north of Lucca to the beautiful medieval city of Barga. Barga prides itself as being the most Scottish place to live in Italy. It even holds an annual fish and chip festival to celebrate the many Italians who emigrated to Scotland during the last century to open fish and chip shops. Among their number from Barga is the great-grandfather of the city's famous son, the singer-songwriter Paolo Nutini. But it's the city's Italian flavour that I'm hoping appeals the most today.
Have you visited here before?
We've never visited here, but our friend actually works quite close to here.
What have you heard about it?
It's a lot like Lucca in a way, like a smaller version, because you have the wall and all the medieval structure inside. Mm-hmm. I mean, it has the feel.
Yeah, it's got
Lucca.
A nice feel about it.
The locals say that every weekend in the summer, if you want a party, you can find a fiesta somewhere in the surrounding villages. So, I think this could be perfect for you guys.
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah.
There's also a little theatre. Is that something you guys consider going to?
In an evening, we try and get in as much culture as we can. So, yeah, the theatre, opera, whatever. Yeah, it's just something different.
Yeah, something different for us.
Well, the property isn't within the city walls.
Yeah. OK.
But it's about 10 minutes from here, so if you wanted to come into the city, it would be kind of a cab ride, or you could get on a bus.
Yeah.
As Barga is more inland and lacks good transport connections to big cities, property here is cheaper than in the Lucca area. The average starting price for a two-bedroom detached house is £180,000. I've found Lee and Lynn a property close to Barga city centre, which should offer them the privacy they want. And because the owner is looking for a quick sale following a divorce, it's within budget.
So here we are.
Wow.
And have you noticed anything, Lee?
It's detached.
It is detached.
Wow.
This property is priced just under £168,000.
Okay.
However, the agent has indicated they would potentially be prepared to go as low as £146,000.
Wow.
I saw that sneaky little look, Lee. What was that about?
Yeah, I really like the price as well.
Originally built in 1700, this two-storey detached house is a great character property with splendid views. It comes with an extensive lawn front garden, perfect for entertaining outdoors. Inside it has a very spacious living room with two sets of French doors. Offering a fresh take on a rustic theme, its modern design carries through to the connecting dining room and kitchen. Upstairs is a large second living area, off which is a good-sized double bedroom with further great views of the surrounding hills. There's also a guest bedroom and a shared bathroom. It's on the market within budget at just under £168,000.
Come into the kitchen.
Ooh.
So there's a sneaky little look between you two there. What was that?
This is nice. This is... Words escape me for once. This is the kind of space where you can cook and talk.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's the proper entertainment space.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Space,
entertaining, yeah.
So, another open fireplace here.
This is the kind of feeling that we wanted. We wanted an open plan where if we have a lot of friends,
mm-hmm.
you just mingle around.
Yeah.
And people aren't segregated.
It's got a good feel about it.
Oh, my. Wow. Is that a bit of a surprise?
Very much.
Big surprise.
It is quite unusual because mm-hmm. you've got a bedroom here, rather large bathroom here, and you've got a smaller bedroom here.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So it is only two bedrooms, but with this huge living area, there's not many walls to knock down, but would you consider putting any up?
Ooh,
I don't know.
That's just not in your remit, is it, Lee? You don't put walls up.
Why change it, though?
Absolutely, it's such a big area and it's a nice, cosy area. For friends and family coming over, you could always have a sofa bed
mm-hmm.
and open it up.
I just thought I could invite more friends to have a party.
You need to walk around this property and see where you're at after you've had a good look around.
OK.
I'll meet you back out front.
OK. This is a nice size.
There's nothing to do. That's what I like about it. This is only ever going to be a single bedroom.
Yeah.
And it'll never be anything else, and we can work with the space in there to make another bedroom if we want to. We don't have to, we can leave it like that.
Yeah.
But we've got the option.
It's got the option to do it.
Blimey.
Oh my god! How big is this?
That's a bathroom and a half. It's fantastic.
This stylish detached house with two bedrooms is full of character and comes with an asking price that's within budget at just under £168,000.
Hi, girls.
Hi.
So, what was being discussed? What did you think?
It's absolutely marvellous.
Yeah, we really like it.
Yeah.
Wow. Is it the dream?
It could be.
I just love the way it's done this look. It could be. Well, it could be or it is.
I think what we need to discuss is not the house in particular. I think it's where
it's the
house
area.
Is.
Yeah.
And
you know,
I think that's what we need to...
The distance from Lucca.
That's what we need to discuss.
Are you still thinking about any other properties that we've seen?
No, I think it's got to be between
the apartment
in Lucca
and this.
We've got to discuss both opportunities, haven't we?
Yeah.
I'm not going to put you on the spot and ask you to tell me now, so take this evening.
Okay.
Don't envy you guys. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
I've shown Lee and Lynn 5 properties here in Lucca for their budget of £170,000. They've ruled out this converted farmhouse with an asking price of just under £117,000, and this barn conversion on the market with a negotiable asking price of just under £190,000. They also discounted this terrace house on the market at just over £175,000, leaving them torn between 2 properties. Their heads love this recently modernised city apartment in Lucca with an asking price of just under £146,000. They were surprised that they could afford to buy inside the city walls and thought it would be an excellent holiday pied-à-terre in a prime location, which they could sell later if they moved out here full-time. But their hearts have been drawn to this detached house in the city of Barga, 1 hour from Lucca, with an asking price of just under £168,000. They loved its views and all its space for entertaining and felt it would make a great permanent home, but they were less convinced by its location so far away from Lucca. I'm interested to find out their final decision.
So, are you still as confused as you were when I left you yesterday?
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Oh, no!
Up to last night at dinner, I think we were leaning towards the property in Barga.
So why was it slightly in the lead up until dinner?
I think it was the outside space and the thought we could have all our family out and mm-hmm. friends and we could entertain and, yeah. and live the life.
Yeah. And obviously there, it's a place that if we did eventually come out here, we wouldn't have to move. It's a property that we could live in and just be happy, really, I think.
Yeah.
You said up until dinner last night, it was the detached property in Barga. Mm-hmm. Has something changed since?
It was just the feeling when we're in Lucca again. And it just pulls.
Yeah.
I know.
I think it's one of those things, it's like, if we do have an apartment within the walls, if we do decide eventually to sell and move out when we know the area better, it's going to be easily... So more easily sold.
So how are you going to come to a decision and what are you going to do?
I know. In my heart of hearts, I know we're going to be out here later on in life. Mm-hmm. But as of now, maybe I should let my head take over and go for the property that is low maintenance, mm-hmm. is possibly easily rentable mm-hmm. when yeah. we're not here, mm-hmm. and is an investment.
But it's your head option, isn't
it's
it?
It's the head option.
And not your heart. Yeah. And the Barga property... is your heart option.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But Lucca is the heart.
As well.
Yeah.
Do you want us to speak to the agent and perhaps, you know, register your interest with both the apartment in Lucca and the house in Barga and make sure the agents let us know if anything happens?
Yeah, that would be good.
Just to keep a little grip on it.
Well, thanks so much, guys. It's been a real pleasure. And let me know what you decide to do.
Okay, we'll do.
On returning home, Lee and Lynn decided that their first love is still the city of Lucca, and they've booked tickets to go back there and see the city apartment again, along with some other properties.